So let's try this again. If you see my last video, you'll see that I put up the accent wall. Here it is. It looks good, right? But again, like I said in the video, there's spots on it that's just not, it's not it. Like, you can see these lines and everything, and while I thought that it wasn't bothering me, it was. So I tried to hide it with picture frames, and the picture frames are good. I like gallery walls, whatever. I like random gallery walls, but it's just not. Like, this piece is perfect. But then as I kept going, and I kept going, and I kept going, it just wasn't looking good. So then I remembered this one method that I forgot at the time, and it's basically you use liquid starch. You put liquid starch on the wall and then you put up your regular wallpaper and it becomes renter friendly. So we're gonna try that instead and we're gonna see how it works out. As far as I know, everyone says that it works out really well. So let's give it a shot, shall we? Here I am just taking down the previous wallpaper that I had up. And like I said, the wallpaper is fine. I love this wallpaper. I'm so glad that I got it and everything. But doing it the other way that you saw in the previous video just wasn't sitting right with me. By the time you saw that video, this wallpaper would have been up for about a month-ish. And the more I looked at it, the more I just hated it. And it's okay to take things down if you don't like them. It's okay to retry and everything. At some point I was trying to save this wallpaper and I was going to try and reuse it, but when I started taking everything down, the tape that really didn't stick that well to the wall stuck to everything else. Like, it wasn't really sticking to the paper that well either, but because the wallpaper is paper, it was still tearing it a little bit, and that was an issue. So at some point you do just see me trying to save it like here, but I gave up and I just ripped it off the wall and just balled it up in anger. I get frustrated very easily. I was just done with it. So right now I'm preparing the liquid starch and everything and getting the wallpaper that I do have. Like, thankfully I had enough to redo the entire wall again. But one thing I want to say, you guys, is shake up the liquid starch, because I did not shake it. It's good to shake the liquid starch. Also, be sure to saturate this wallpaper. Just slather as much on it as you can, because the process got easier as I went along, but at the beginning it was just very, very tedious. I feel like it's working, but I do have to put nails at the top, and I need to repaste this one, the first one. I feel like it's working a lot better. It's not bubbling up, but at the same time, like, you can just see this right here, which is the liquid starch, but I think after it dries, everything looks fine. Again, it's just me being impatient, but I do have to repaste that and everything. It's a more involved process. Like, it's definitely a more involved process than just using the tape and putting it on there with double-sided tape and everything, but I really wanted this to work. I struggled a bit to get it done, and I only have three up. But I do have a whole nother roll left, so that should be fine. So my phone's dying and I forgot to charge it. So I will just fill you guys in. I should be able to charge it while it's recording me. So I'm gonna do that and you guys can watch me struggle. Okay. At some point, I did find a, what's the word? I did find a technique that worked a little bit better. I would basically just cut the wallpaper before I put it on the wall. I would just let it drop, cut the wallpaper, and then for the top part, I would put the liquid starch on there, and then I would put it on the wall, and then I would nail it to the wall. That way it would stay while I am putting liquid starch on the rest of the wallpaper and the wall. You want to do it on both. And then I would just smooth it out. I couldn't find my wallpaper smoother. I have no idea where it was, and I just wanted to get this done. That what I just pointed out, that technique did not work. It was like me just putting the liquid starch on the wallpaper before I put it up on the wall. That really didn't work for me. At least I don't think it did. It was a lot more tedious. But this technique right there, that one worked. Putting the paste on, pasting the wall, and then like flattening it out, that worked. The other one didn't, so I continued to do that instead. See right here, this was me being impatient and I ripped the wallpaper a little bit. I am gonna cover the top part with like some renter friendly crown molding once I find some. But again, guys, just take your time. Don't be like me. I just really wanted this accent wall to work so badly that I was just completely impatient with it. I also came to realize one thing is that wallpaper can take being creased like this. It doesn't matter because once you paste it on the wall, you really can't see where you creased it at. I didn't know that was a thing. I know I looked at the listing for this wallpaper and it said like the curls at the end, once you paste it, it won't be shown, or you won't see those creases. So I just decided to go ahead and start creasing it like that, and it was perfectly fine once I smoothed everything out. It didn't affect anything at all. And just like in my last video, this method is a lot cheaper than buying peel and stick wallpaper. Peel and stick wallpaper costs like $20 per roll, and you really don't get that much. So you would have to buy multiple rolls, especially from the same printing lot, because if you buy it at different times, it's going to be different colors. But this right here, so much cheaper, so much more affordable. It's just a lot more involved than peel and stick wallpaper.
I'm tired and my back hurts and I still need to clean my house. But the accent wall, it looks so much better now. I'm so excited. I can't wait to actually hang up the pictures and everything. I have to put the chest set back and then I have to vacuum the house just because like I haven't vacuumed in a few days, but it looks so much better. Let me show you. Like, look at that. Like, the top, like, I didn't cut it even.
I don't know how people do that. I have no idea how they cut it even. And then for the bottom half, it is a little bit shorter than what it originally was. I think originally it was like down here a few inches, but that's okay as well. I might have to get more of this chair rail thing because I had extra, but that's one roll, and then this is part of the other, and I used the same one from the previous one, but somehow it was a little short and I had to cut again. I don't know how that happened, but everything is dry, everything looks good, and like I was saying, the liquid starch just had to dry, and now it just looks really, it looks so good. I am much, much happier with this than I was with the other renter-friendly hack that I made. So this is the hack. This one. This is the hack you need to use.